Trigger alert. The critical and predictionary nature of this video might trigger tech enthusiasts and AI evangelists. 1822. The race begins when the world was introduced to a machine called a computer. Ever since, we've spent time, money, and other auxiliary resources improving this machine. Now, we are now at a point when they are not only fast and robust, but they have intelligence of their own. But what is next? Is this the end of the race? Or are we further going to sink down this rabbit hole? Let's find out. While I was searching for the answers, I landed across many fancy terms that went like singularity, superintelligence, Skynet, and apocalypse. I am sure you must be familiar with the last two. I actually found myself more involved in the first two. So, what exactly do we mean by singularity? By definition, it is a hypothetical point in the future where artificial intelligence will surpass human intelligence and lead to an exponential growth in technological progress. This concept was popularized by mathematician and computer scientist Werner Vinge in 1993. To bring everything into perspective, let me take you back in time, when the Iron Age transitioned to the Industrial Age, or when the Atomic Age gave way to the Information Age. Each of these moments represented a time of rapid technological growth that would have seemed unimaginable just years before. These major turning points don't have to be limited to human history, but can also include inventions like the pulley and the wheel. Those who see the concept of a singularity more broadly believe that many more of these turning points are yet to come. Currently, we are on the verge of another such moment, thanks to AI and nanotechnology. Scientists predict that by the 2030s, nanobots will become a huge part of our lives. The interesting thing about this upcoming singularity is that we don't need any more intelligence than we have now. We just need to put in the work to make plausible inventions. By placing artificial intelligence in a non-human form, we could free up a massive amount of time for processing other data. Who knows, in 2070 or something, we might have gadgets around that would omit the need of going to the hospital for a checkup. Now, the idea that machines actually start to replace and outperform humans in almost all professional roles is known as superintelligence. This is the ultimate form of singularity, and the point where things start to get dark. Physicist Stephen Hawking once warned us by saying that the development of full artificial intelligence could spell the end of the human race. He believed that once humans develop full AI, it will take off on its own and redesign itself at an ever-increasing rate. He also claimed that humans who are limited by slow biological evolution would not be able to compete and will fall prey to their own creation. Just imagine the scenario when the world is full of hundreds or even millions of Einsteins that automatically analyze and find a solution to every problem and start force implementing it. We might be approaching that time sooner than we estimate, courtesy of algorithms consistently becoming more complex and neural networks becoming more intricate. The line between artificial intelligence and superintelligence might soon begin to blur. The machines we've built to serve us could soon become our equals, or even our masters, as they acquire knowledge and understanding beyond our wildest imaginings. Even the biggest proponents of AI are worried about this situation. Last year, while speaking at an MIT symposium, Elon Musk said, "I think we should be very careful about AI. If I were to guess what our greatest existential threat is, I'd probably say it's that. With artificial intelligence, we are summoning the demon." Bill Gates, another major proponent of AI, recently documented that he finds himself in the camp that is concerned about superintelligence. The next question that immediately pops up is what we humans can do to compete with this kind of superintelligence. Is there a way to stop or even delay this apocalypse? Well, in the world of futuristic ideas, there is one theory that has surely caught people's attention. It suggests that if we can connect our brains with machines, we might be able to boost our intelligence to incredible levels. People argue about whether this is possible, or if we have to wait for humans to evolve into a smarter species. Out of all the possibilities, becoming super intelligent seems most likely, but it's still far away. We don't have the technology, knowledge of the human brain, or the ability to create a general artificial intelligence yet. This could happen someday, but we're probably several generations away from seeing it. However, we have one such example, In 1997, Deep Blue, a powerful AI of that time, defeated chess champion Garry Kasparov. Fast forward 20 years, and human chess masters can't even defeat an AI on a laptop. However, Kasparov introduced a new type of chess contest where humans and AI work together, achieving more than either could alone. In these collaborations, the computer quickly calculates possible moves, while the human player selects the best option, understanding and outsmarting their opponent. Again, the concern is that we are not making breakthroughs in competing superintelligence at the pace we are creating it. During my research, I found that many experts with extensive portfolios in the field believe that this intelligence explosion is unavoidable. They think that once we make superintelligent AI, it will be the last invention humans ever need to create. This idea and the term intelligence explosion were first introduced in 1965 by British mathematician I.J. Goode, who worked along with Alan Turing. The idea is often repeated, and the creation of an artificial superintelligence is seen as the ultimate goal of the singularity. Once this superintelligent machine exists and has upgraded itself beyond our understanding, it's impossible to predict what will happen next. So, if we have prepared the recipe for our death, you must be wondering how long it will take to kickstart the AI apocalypse. To better understand the situation, I would like to introduce you to two more terms, i.e. intuitive physics and one-shot learning. Intuitive physics pertains to the human ability to anticipate dynamic alterations in their physical surroundings and subsequently respond accordingly. An example of this is detecting the path of a tumbling tree and determining which way to move for evading contact. One-shot learning involves the capacity to classify objects after being exposed to only a handful of examples. This skill appears to be something that machines currently struggle with, at least for the moment. Experts from MIT made an estimate by using these two metrics, and according to what they suggest, that human-level machine intelligence, or HLMI, has a 50% chance of occurring within 45 years, and a 10% chance of occurring within 9 years. I'm assuming that after 2 or 3 decades of HLMI, things would start moving towards intelligence explosion. So, as someone in my early 30s, I personally think that my grandchildren would be among the unfortunate to see it all happen in front of their eyes. Unless you are a blind fan of AI development, I personally think that nothing should be stopping you from hitting that subscribe button. I would definitely want to see your opinion on this topic. Oh my god, I cannot believe how lucky you are that there's a comment section just below the video. Till next time, goodbye.